our mental health. It's Niall Breslin and Susan Quirk from The Lust for Life.
There isn't one person in this room, in some capacity, that hasn't been directly or indirectly affected by mental health issues and the stigma that for too long has surrounded it. I could easily stand up here and proclaim the devastating statistics we read and hear every single day, but we truly feel that doesn't describe the true extent of the problem in our society when it comes to mental health. As I grew up with an anxiety disorder, hell-bent on destroying every career and relationship I faced, I slowly made the realization that it was never my mental health that I simply could not cope with. It was the constant excuses I had to make for it, the energy it took to disguise it, and the mask that I had to wear to protect myself from a stigma that often scared me more than my torturous mind did. And these are the foundations upon which the Lust for Life are built. For if I were to go through that darkness again, I know it would be a much brighter journey because of the work that we do. So what is it that we do? We are a national movement for well-being. Our website, lustforlife.com, has helped guide, educate, and support over 1 million people in the last 12 months by normalising the conversation around mental health. Over 13,000 people have done our events, which aim at building solidarity and community all throughout Ireland. Our advocacy work has allowed us work at a policy-influencing level with our allies in the mental health community by joining the dots collectively and highlighting the absolute need to facilitate change in this country when it comes to mental health. Our media partnerships have allowed us to magnify stories that otherwise weren't being heard, and that's allowing for cultural change and societal change when it comes to the attitude towards mental health, and that will go a long way with destroying the stigma that is destroying too many people. Yet we are only just beginning.
Creating change in the world can be incredibly lonely and difficult. It's not easy trying to change old ways and break through old paradigms that no longer serve us, trying to forge new pathways ahead. And we have sometimes felt suffocated by our own needs and struggles whilst trying to meet the needs of others. But we have never once questioned our vocation, our unflinching dedication to doing everything that we can to co-create a society, a culture that nourishes compassion, support, healing, hope. Niall and I would not be standing on the stage here tonight if it wasn't for some phenomenal people who have walked this journey with us. And we are especially grateful to our co-founders, Derry McVeigh, Hugh Cafferty, and Pritesh Patel. And likewise, our first follower, Dr. Manny Coyne, guided us through some critical junctures when we really needed support in our early days. So thank you all. There are so many other people that we could thank. Such a phenomenal community has surrounded us in this journey. A community of people who align with our vision, which is a world where the well-being of humanity is the headliner on the main stage, and everything else is a support act. And that includes Social Entrepreneurs of Ireland, who are honouring us with this award. We are so humbled to be standing here on this stage receiving this award, considering all of those who have come before us, considering the people who we've shared this process with, considering so many people who are in this room tonight who are dedicating their life force to creating social change in Ireland, and so many people who are here with them, loving, guiding, and supporting them, and that is just as important. So we know that life is short, life is precious, life can be bloody hard at times, and beautiful all at once. But we at A Lust for Life are doing everything that we can to continue to support, inspire, uplift, guide, empower people to live a life that they deserve to live. Because we all deserve to live a good life. Thank you.